Welcome, Frauke. Thank you so much that you want to join us for a lecture about emotions and the patient journey. The students already saw your introduction, so just let's dig in. So you make a lot of patient journeys, and in your journeys, who are the most relevant actors, or who do you distinguish as the most relevant actors?
Well, actually, in my journeys, there's usually just one actor. Because in the journeys that I create, it's most often about the experience of one individual user who's using a product or a service over time. So in some cases, sometimes there are two actors that interact, for example, a doctor and a patient. And in such an example, you can represent like how a doctor experiences the situation. And in this example, for example, it's a 12-minute consultation time between a doctor and a patient. And on the lower side, you see how the patient experienced those 12 minutes of consultation time. But in general, they just represent the experience of one typical user.
Okay, but if you create not for a lot of stakeholders, but just for a single user, what are then the ingredients of your journey? So how do you create them?
Yes, well, it really depends on what you want to use the journeys for. So you can use journeys in design for understanding your user group better, for ideating, coming up to new ideas that better fulfill their needs, or for decision making. When you as a company want to decide on what phases you want to invest your budget on. So that really depends on the ingredients of a journey. But in general, the most important part are the phases. Because a journey represents how a service or a product is experienced over time. And then you can divide it up on the phases. An experience is not an isolated, static experience. So this over time issue is the big benefit from using journey mapping, I would say. And then you have all these rows in journeys. Mm-hmm. And it really depends on what aim you want to use the journey for, what you want to put in. But you can use all kind of different things, like...
Okay, do you have some examples?
Yeah, like the faces, of course, and a good description of each face, I think, is really important. You can make sub-faces, and then what people experience. So that can be what people do, what are they thinking, what are their emotions, what are their motives or their values, the motivations, all these kind of different things. But you can also use it for opportunities or insights or barriers or pain points they find on the way or the touch points with a service.
Mm-hmm. And you mentioned like touch points or behavior that's very, it's easy to observe, but you also mentioned something about emotions. That's very tangible. How can you actually include that? Can you tell me a little bit more about that?
Yes, that's really from the point of view when you use journeys for understanding your user group better, because understanding is really based on empathy, and to try and to understand how a product or a service is experienced from a person's point of view, you need to step into their shoes. And then you also need those emotions to really be able to step in to take that perspective.
Okay, and do you have kind of an example where you use that? And can you explain a little bit more about that?
Well, one of the recent projects that we've been working on is a journey for people living with diabetes. And we are doing this project for a company called Roche Diabetes Care. They are an international pharmaceutical client, and they develop products and services for people with diabetes. Those services are all kind of different things, also trainings together with healthcare professionals. And they have a lot of market research data available, mm-hmm. but they really wanted to understand what it means for people to live with diabetes in their everyday lives. So we conducted a lot of research. We did interviews in the US, Germany, and the Netherlands. And based on those interviews, we developed two archetypical journeys. One for type 1 and one for type 2 diabetes.
Okay, and can you explain something about how they look like, those two types of journeys, and maybe something about the difference between those two?
Yes, and in these two journeys we really focused on the main phases of having diabetes in your everyday life, because one of the main insights was actually that people, they don't like to be seen as a patient, and they also don't like to be treated as a patient. maybe in the beginning when they have to start using diabetes management products, but over a while it's a lifelong disease. So they just want to be human beings, people like everyone else, and then they also have diabetes. So the two main phases that we used in our journeys was like diagnosis and learning phase, mm-hmm. with all kind of subphases, and the integrating in my everyday life phase. Yeah. And the way we tried to word or title those phases was really important, also to convey how it is to live with diabetes, to really take the perspective of people living with diabetes.
So then you included again those emotions.
We included also in these journeys really, really carefully the emotions, in this way through a graph. So you can also do it with smileys or plus or minus. And now we had a graph of plus and minus when it's positive or negative. But we also try to nuance the emotions. So we put words in it, such as chaos or despair. And then we added little quotes from the interviews, actual raw quotes of what people said, to try to explain it better, what this emotion mean for people.
Okay, interesting. And so then you have a lot of information, but how does the client actually use this kind of roadmaps?
In this case, they literally asked for journeys that can be used in ideation sessions. Okay. So together with some videos of the interviews, this served as inspiration for creating new solutions to better serve the needs of these people. But later in the process, they made a more abstracted version, a more simple version, and they sent it through the entire organization in order to create a more empathic mindset towards their customers.
Oh, wow. Yes. Really beautiful.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. And hopefully it helps our students to understand how they can actually apply those insights you just disclosed with us.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you.